Now, the increased defense spending comes as Russia's central bank warns economic growth is set to slow down in the second half of 2023, with inflation above the bank's target of 4%. President Putin and other officials have largely shrugged off the economic effects of Ukraine offensive, arguing that Russia has largely weathered the storm of Western sanctions here.
Russian President Vladimir Putin has signed a decree setting out the routine seasonal conscription campaign. As per a document posted on Moscow's government website, he has called at least 130,000 citizens to contribute to statutory military service. The document states that all Russian men in the age bracket of 18 to 27 years are required to do a year-long military training. The move has followed through as the Russian armed forces continue to press on with their special military operation in Ukraine, the same war that is now in its 20th month. Earlier this year, another similar order was signed calling upon 100,047 people for the spring campaign. However, the recent announcement comes on the heels of President Putin's statement that this month his government is bracing for a longer battle in Ukraine. As per Moscow's defense ministry, the recent conscription will include, for the first time, men from four occupied regions in Ukraine. Men from Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson, and Zaporizhia will be part of the induction. In fact, in July this year, Russia's lower house of parliament voted to raise the maximum age of conscription from 27 to 30 years. The new legislation has been given a green flag and will come into effect starting 1st of January next year. The large-scale forced mobilization has been coined due to substantial losses at the front and will unfold from October to December. Last year, Moscow trumpeted an ambitious plan to boost its professional and conscripted combatants. The decided jump in numbers was more than 30%, loosely making up about 1.5 million personnel. How are people reacting to this? Are they in favor of the move? Well, the UK Defense Intelligence assessed that high desertion betrays the morale of the Russian troops. However, at the same time, high military wages and additional payments serve as strong incentives for Russians to join into the ranks of Moscow's forces. These mass recruitments especially appeal to those residing in impoverished regions of Russia.
It is 5 months since the civil war broke out in Sudan, but the brutality and mayhem that began on the 15th of April continues unabated. This week, a video of two RSF soldiers standing in front of one of Khartoum's most iconic skyscrapers has gone viral. The skyscraper that towers over the Nile River has been reduced to a smoldering shell. The fact that cultural heritage sites of Sudan were being reduced to rubble in the Sudanese civil war is no secret. But what is new is the scale of the devastation that has come to light. At the same time, the street fighting in Sudan is also fast becoming a theater of a proxy war between the Wagner mercenaries and the agents of the Ukrainian intelligence agencies. Now, you may wonder, what role do Russia and Ukraine have to play in the civil war in Sudan? In our next report, we get you the details of how Ukraine is trying to crush the Wagner mercenaries inside Sudan.
This video from the 17th of September is from the Sudanese capital Khartoum. Two RSF soldiers with their guns rested on their shoulders accused the Sudanese National Army of using air power to bomb civilian locations. This region is the confluence of the Blue and the White Niles. Until some months back, was the hub of Khartoum's financial district. In a recorded speech put out by the RSF militia chief General Degallo, he's warned that Sudan is again headed for yet another partition. So as the two generals battle it out for supremacy, the common people are the ones who are caught in a meat grinder. Driven out from their homes, they've pitched temporary tents along the border with Chad. In West Darfur, the civil war has again acquired a tribal and ethnic dimension. The non-Arab Masalit people are facing the brunt of violence here. From the beginning of the conflict, the Russian Wagner militia has been actively aiding the RSF paramilitary group of General Degallo. And now, a series of drone attacks on Wagner assets in Sudan is raising some very uncomfortable questions. Take a look at this dramatic video shot using a drone. Experts have geolocated the strike to have taken place on the Shambat Bridge, which connects Omdurman and Khartoum. In the last fortnight, a series of such drone attacks in Sudan have taken everyone by surprise. The tactic of drones swooping down directly onto the target has so far been unusual in Sudan and the wider African region. Interestingly, Ukraine has not directly claimed these attacks, but top sources within the Ukrainian military have admitted that attacks on Wagner militia in Khartoum and Omdurman are the handiwork of non-Sudanese military. The Sudanese National Army insists that it has no information on these attacks, while the Americans have refused to comment on the new drone tactics that are being witnessed. This video shot using a night vision camera is purportedly of foreign fighters conducting a raid on a building in Omdurman. On the 6th of September, the Wagner militia reportedly facilitated the transfer of a large convoy of arms to the RSF, including anti-air defense missiles. Covert strikes by Ukraine in Sudan points to a provocative expansion of the war theater. Drone tactics like this have earlier been used in the war theaters of Libya, Ethiopia, and Nigeria. But this is the first time that they've been deployed in the Sudanese civil war. And worryingly, it is an outside power that has now deployed them in the Sudanese conflict.
The war in Ukraine has stretched beyond 580 days now, and the tensions seem to be mounting along the front lines. The global economic order has changed significantly since February 2022, when the war began. So, what's the human cost of the ongoing war? What do the numbers suggest? Take a look and find out.
February 2022, Russia began its so-called military operation on Ukrainian soil. Ukraine has since found support among the United States and its allies, despite not being inducted into NATO. Economic sanctions since then have hit Russia hard, but the economic implications of the war stretch far beyond the countries involved and their allies. A globally interconnected supply chain means everyone in the world has felt the pain of the war. For developing countries like Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh and others, the World Bank's projection as of March 2023 is grim, suggesting that the Ukraine conflict could impose a hefty annual burden of $70 billion. This daunting figure stems from several factors, including surging food and energy prices, sluggish economic growth and disruptions in trade and investment. Advanced economies are not immune to the repercussions. The United States is facing the biggest losses. Some estimates suggest it could cost Uncle Sam $1.5 trillion over the next decade, while the Eurozone is expected to face losses over $1 trillion during this time. The German economy, currently in recession, is expected to fare the worst. But the economic losses faced by these countries is nowhere close to what it could cost Ukraine. The Kiev School of Economics estimated in March 2023 that the direct economic losses to Ukraine from the war could reach $500 billion. That is larger than Ukraine's pre-war GDP of $350 billion. Beyond the economic toll, the Ukraine war has also spawned a significant humanitarian crisis. Millions of Ukrainians have been forcibly displaced, their lives upended by violence and uncertainty. Tragically, thousands have lost their lives in the conflict. Moreover, the war's disruption of global food supplies looms as a potential precursor to a hunger crisis in various parts of the world. But despite the humanitarian crisis and the cost of war, Russia is not backing down. Bloomberg Economics estimated in March 2023 that Russia had lost $350 billion in economic output since the start of the war due to a combination of sanctions and the war effort itself. The Center for Strategic and International Studies estimated in March 2023 that the cost of the war to Russia could reach $7 trillion over the next decade. While these estimates provide a stark picture of the economic and humanitarian costs, it's crucial to recognize that they remain preliminary. The full extent of the war's impact is yet to unfold, underscoring the urgency of concerted international efforts to address both the immediate crisis and its long-term aftermath. As the world watches and hopes for a resolution to the conflict, it's clear that the ramifications of the Russia-Ukraine war reverberate far beyond the borders of the nations directly involved. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.
Moving on, as per reports, President Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine continues to adversely impact Russia's economy.
And it has forced the leader to review his budget priorities. But instead of what at least NATO would have expected, Russia has now plans of a massive increase in defense spending next year.
I'd say, Shivan, this doesn't really come as much of a surprise. I guess this was expected at this point in the war.
What option do they have left right now?
Right.
They have to spend on it.
One would assume, right. And according to a Russian finance ministry document now published on Thursday, Russia is set to hike defense spending by almost 70% in 2024. The cost of the jump is calculated at over 10.8 trillion rubles. That's about $111 billion, totaling around 6% of the GDP. Further classified expenditures will rise to 11.1 trillion rubles from 6.5 trillion for 2023, and spending on social policies, that's planned to reach 7.5 trillion rubles in 2024, up from 6.5 trillion in 2023. Defense spending is set to total around three times more than education, environmental protection and healthcare spending combined in 2024. These are the figures that were calculated by AFP. Russian Finance Ministry document also stated that the increased expenditure will help boost strengthening the country's defense capacity and integrating the four Ukrainian regions, which Moscow claimed to annex last year. These are Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson and Zaporizhia. Now the increased defense spending comes as Russia's central bank warns economic growth is set to slow down in the second half of 2023, with inflation above the bank's target of 4%. President Putin and other officials have largely shrugged off the economic effects of Ukraine offensive, arguing that Russia has largely weathered the storm of Western sanctions here.
Russian President Vladimir Putin has signed a decree setting out the routine seasonal conscription campaign. As per a document posted on Moscow's government website, he has called at least 130,000 citizens to contribute to statutory military service. The document states that all Russian men in the age bracket of 18 to 27 years are required to do a year-long military training. The move has followed through as the Russian armed forces continue to press on with their special military operation in Ukraine, the same war that is now in its 20th month. Earlier this year, another similar order was signed calling upon 100,047 people for the spring campaign. However, the recent announcement comes on the heels of President Putin's statement that this month his government is bracing for a longer battle in Ukraine. As per Moscow's defense ministry, the recent conscription will include, for the first time, men from four occupied regions in Ukraine. Men from Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson, and Zaporizhia will be part of the induction. In fact, in July this year, Russia's lower house of parliament voted to raise the maximum age of conscription from 27 to 30 years. The new legislation has been given a green flag and will come into effect starting 1st of January next year. The large-scale forced mobilization has been coined due to substantial losses at the front and will unfold from October to December. Last year, Moscow trumpeted an ambitious plan to boost its professional and conscripted combatants. The decided jump in numbers was more than 30%, loosely making up about 1.5 million personnel. How are people reacting to this? Are they in favor of the move? Well, the UK Defense Intelligence assessed that high desertion betrays the morale of the Russian troops. However, at the same time, high military wages and additional payments serve as strong incentives for Russians to join into the ranks of Moscow's forces. These mass recruitments especially appeal to those residing in impoverished regions of Russia.
It is 5 months since the civil war broke out in Sudan, but the brutality and mayhem that began on the 15th of April continues unabated. This week, A video of two RSF soldiers standing in front of one of Khartoum's most iconic skyscrapers has gone viral. The skyscraper that towers over the Nile River has been reduced to a smoldering shell. The fact that cultural heritage sites of Sudan were being reduced to rubble in the Sudanese civil war is no secret. But what is new is the scale of the devastation that has come to light. At the same time, the street fighting in Sudan is also fast becoming a theater of a proxy war between the Wagner mercenaries and the agents of the Ukrainian intelligence agencies. Now, you may wonder, what role do Russia and Ukraine have to play in the civil war in Sudan? In our next report, we get you the details of how Ukraine is trying to crush the Wagner mercenaries inside Sudan.
This video from the 17th of September is from the Sudanese capital Khartoum. Two RSF soldiers with their guns rested on their shoulders accused the Sudanese National Army of using air power to bomb civilian locations. This region is the confluence of the Blue and the White Niles. Until some months back, was the hub of Khartoum's financial district. In a recorded speech put out by the RSF militia chief General Degalo, he's warned that Sudan is again headed for yet another partition. So as the two generals battle it out for supremacy, the common people are the ones who are caught in a meat grinder. Driven out from their homes, they've pitched temporary tents along the border with Chad. In West Darfur, the civil war has again acquired a tribal and ethnic dimension. The non-Arab Masalit people are facing the brunt of violence here. From the beginning of the conflict, the Russian Wagner militia has been actively aiding the RSF paramilitary group of General Degalo. And now, a series of drone attacks on Wagner assets in Sudan is raising some very uncomfortable questions. Take a look at this dramatic video shot using a drone. Experts have geolocated this strike to have taken place on the Shambat Bridge, which connects Omdurman and Khartoum. In the last fortnight, a series of such drone attacks in Sudan have taken everyone by surprise. The tactic of drones swooping down directly onto the target has so far been unusual in Sudan and the wider African region. Interestingly, Ukraine has not directly claimed these attacks, but top sources within the Ukrainian military have admitted that attacks on Wagner militia in Khartoum and Omdurman are the handiwork of non-Sudanese military. The Sudanese National Army insists that it has no information on these attacks, while the Americans have refused to comment on the new drone tactics that are being witnessed. This video shot using a night vision camera is purportedly of foreign fighters conducting a raid on a building in Omdurman. On the 6th of September, the Wagner militia reportedly facilitated the transfer of a large convoy of arms to the RSF, including anti-air defense missiles. Covert strikes by Ukraine in Sudan point to a provocative expansion of the war theater. Drone tactics like this have earlier been used in the war theaters of Libya, Ethiopia, and Nigeria. But this is the first time that they've been deployed in the Sudanese civil war. And worryingly, it is an outside power that has now deployed them in the Sudanese conflict.
The war in Ukraine has stretched beyond 580 days now, and the tensions seem to be mounting along the front lines. The global economic order has changed significantly since February 2022, when the war began. So, what's the human cost of the ongoing war? What do the numbers suggest? Take a look and find out.
February 2022, Russia began its so-called military operation on Ukrainian soil. Ukraine has since found support among the United States and its allies, despite not being inducted into NATO. Economic sanctions since then have hit Russia hard, but the economic implications of the war stretch far beyond the countries involved and their allies. A globally interconnected supply chain means everyone in the world has felt the pain of the war. For developing countries like Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh and others, the World Bank's projection as of March 2023 is grim, suggesting that the Ukraine conflict could impose a hefty annual burden of $70 billion. This daunting figure stems from several factors, including surging food and energy prices, sluggish economic growth and disruptions in trade and investment. Advanced economies are not immune to the repercussions. The United States is facing the biggest losses. Some estimates suggest it could cost Uncle Sam $1.5 trillion over the next decade, while the Eurozone is expected to face losses over $1 trillion during this time. The German economy, currently in recession, is expected to fare the worst. But the economic losses faced by these countries is nowhere close to what it could cost Ukraine. The Kiev School of Economics estimated in March 2023 that the direct economic losses to Ukraine from the war could reach $500 billion. That is larger than Ukraine's pre-war GDP of $350 billion. Beyond the economic toll, the Ukraine war has also spawned a significant humanitarian crisis. Millions of Ukrainians have been forcibly displaced, their lives upended by violence and uncertainty. Tragically, thousands have lost their lives in the conflict. Moreover, the war's disruption of global food supplies looms as a potential precursor to a hunger crisis in various parts of the world. But despite the humanitarian crisis and the cost of war, Russia is not backing down. Bloomberg Economics estimated in March 2023 that Russia had lost $350 billion in economic output since the start of the war due to a combination of sanctions and the war effort itself. The Center for Strategic and International Studies estimated in March 2023 that the cost of the war to Russia could reach $7 trillion over the next decade. While these estimates provide a stark picture of the economic and humanitarian costs, it's crucial to recognize that they remain preliminary. The full extent of the war's impact is yet to unfold, underscoring the urgency of concerted international efforts to address both the immediate crisis and its long-term aftermath. As the world watches and hopes for a resolution to the conflict, it's clear that the ramifications of the Russia-Ukraine war reverberate far beyond the borders of the nations directly involved. Bureau Report, WION. World is one.
Moving on, as per reports, President Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine continues to adversely impact Russia's economy.
And it has forced the leader to review his budget priorities. But instead of what at least NATO would have expected, Russia has now plans of a massive increase in defense spending next year.
I'd say, Shivan, this doesn't really come as much of a surprise. I guess this was expected at this point in the war.
What option do they have left right now?
Right.
They have to spend on it.
One would assume, right. And according to a Russian finance ministry document now published on Thursday, Russia is set to hike defense spending by almost 70% in 2024. The cost of the jump is calculated at over 10.8 trillion rubles. That's about $111 billion, totaling around 6% of the GDP. Further classified expenditures will rise to 11.1 trillion rubles from 6.5 trillion for 2023, and spending on social policies, that's planned to reach 7.5 trillion rubles in 2024, up from 6.5 trillion in 2023. Defense spending is set to total around three times more than education, environmental protection and healthcare spending combined in 2024. These are the figures that were calculated by AFP. Russian Finance Ministry document also stated that the increased expenditure will help boost strengthening the country's defense capacity and integrating the four Ukrainian regions, which Moscow claimed to annex last year. These are Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson and Zaporizhia. Now the increased defense spending comes as Russia's central bank warns economic growth is set to slow down in the second half of 2023, with inflation above the bank's target of 4%. President Putin and other officials have largely shrugged off the economic effects of Ukraine offensive, arguing that Russia has largely weathered the storm of Western sanctions here.
Russian President Vladimir Putin has signed a decree setting out the routine seasonal conscription campaign. As per a document posted on Moscow's government website, he has called at least 130,000 citizens to contribute to statutory military service. The document states that all Russian men in the age bracket of 18 to 27 years are required to do a year-long military training. The move has followed through as the Russian armed forces continue to press on with their special military operation in Ukraine, the same war that is now in its 20th month. Earlier this year, another similar order was signed calling upon 100,047 people for the spring campaign. However, the recent announcement comes on the heels of President Putin's statement that this month his government is bracing for a longer battle in Ukraine. As per Moscow's defense ministry, the recent conscription will include, for the first time, men from four occupied regions in Ukraine. Men from Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson, and Zaporizhia will be part of the induction. In fact, in July this year, Russia's lower house of parliament voted to raise the maximum age of conscription from 27 to 30 years. The new legislation has been given a green flag and will come into effect starting 1st of January next year. The large-scale forced mobilization has been coined due to substantial losses at the front and will unfold from October to December. Last year, Moscow trumpeted an ambitious plan to boost its professional and conscripted combatants. The decided jump in numbers was more than 30%, loosely making up about 1.5 million personnel. How are people reacting to this? Are they in favor of the move? Well, the UK Defense Intelligence assessed that high desertion betrays the morale of the Russian troops. However, at the same time, high military wages and additional payments serve as strong incentives for Russians to join into the ranks of Moscow's forces. These mass recruitments especially appeal to those residing in impoverished regions of Russia.
It is 5 months since the civil war broke out in Sudan, but the brutality and mayhem that began on the 15th of April continues unabated. This week, a video of two RSF soldiers standing in front of one of Khartoum's most iconic skyscrapers has gone viral. The skyscraper that towers over the Nile River has been reduced to a smoldering shell. The fact that cultural heritage sites of Sudan were being reduced to rubble in the Sudanese civil war is no secret. But what is new is the scale of the devastation that has come to light. At the same time, the street fighting in Sudan is also fast becoming a theater of a proxy war between the Wagner mercenaries and the agents of the Ukrainian intelligence agencies. Now, you may wonder, what role do Russia and Ukraine have to play in the civil war in Sudan? In our next report, we get you the details of how Ukraine is trying to crush the Wagner mercenaries inside Sudan.
This video from the 17th of September is from the Sudanese capital Khartoum. Two RSF soldiers with their guns rested on their shoulders accused the Sudanese National Army of using air power to bomb civilian locations. This region is the confluence of the Blue and the White Niles. Until some months back, was the hub of Khartoum's financial district. In a recorded speech put out by the RSF militia chief General Degallo, he's warned that Sudan is again headed for yet another partition. So as the two generals battle it out for supremacy, the common people are the ones who are caught in a meat grinder. Driven out from their homes, they've pitched temporary tents along the border with Chad. In West Darfur, the civil war has again acquired a tribal and ethnic dimension. The non-Arab Masalit people are facing the brunt of violence here. From the beginning of the conflict, the Russian Wagner militia has been actively aiding the RSF paramilitary group of General Degallo. And now, a series of drone attacks on Wagner assets in Sudan is raising some very uncomfortable questions. Take a look at this dramatic video shot using a drone. Experts have geolocated the strike to have taken place on the Shambat Bridge, which connects Omdurman and Khartoum. In the last fortnight, a series of such drone attacks in Sudan have taken everyone by surprise. The tactic of drones swooping down directly onto the target has so far been unusual in Sudan and the wider African region. Interestingly, Ukraine has not directly claimed these attacks, but top sources within the Ukrainian military have admitted that attacks on Wagner militia in Khartoum and Omdurman are the handiwork of non-Sudanese military. The Sudanese National Army insists that it has no information on these attacks, while the Americans have refused to comment on the new drone tactics that are being witnessed. This video shot using a night vision camera is purportedly of foreign fighters conducting a raid on a building in Omdurman. On the 6th of September, the Wagner militia reportedly facilitated the transfer of a large convoy of arms to the RSF, including anti-air defense missiles. Covert strikes by Ukraine in Sudan point to a provocative expansion of the war theater. Drone tactics like this have earlier been used in the war theaters of Libya, Ethiopia, and Nigeria. But this is the first time that they've been deployed in the Sudanese civil war. And worryingly, it is an outside power that has now deployed them in the Sudanese conflict.
The war in Ukraine has stretched beyond 580 days now, and the tensions seem to be mounting along the front lines. The global economic order has changed significantly since February 2022, when the war began. So, what's the human cost of the ongoing war? What do the numbers suggest? Take a look and find out.
February 2022, Russia began its so-called military operation on Ukrainian soil. Ukraine has since found support among the United States and its allies, despite not being inducted into NATO. Economic sanctions since then have hit Russia hard, but the economic implications of the war stretch far beyond the countries involved and their allies. A globally interconnected supply chain means everyone in the world has felt the pain of the war. For developing countries like Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh and others, the World Bank's projection as of March 2023 is grim, suggesting that the Ukraine conflict could impose a hefty annual burden of $70 billion. This daunting figure stems from several factors, including surging food and energy prices, sluggish economic growth and disruptions in trade and investment. Advanced economies are not immune to the repercussions. The United States is facing the biggest losses. Some estimates suggest it could cost Uncle Sam $1.5 trillion over the next decade, while the Eurozone is expected to face losses over $1 trillion during this time. The German economy, currently in recession, is expected to fare the worst. But the economic losses faced by these countries is nowhere close to what it could cost Ukraine. The Kiev School of Economics estimated in March 2023 that the direct economic losses to Ukraine from the war could reach $500 billion. That is larger than Ukraine's pre-war GDP of $350 billion. Beyond the economic toll, the Ukraine war has also spawned a significant humanitarian crisis. Millions of Ukrainians have been forcibly displaced, their lives upended by violence and uncertainty. Tragically, thousands have lost their lives in the conflict. Moreover, the war's disruption of global food supplies looms as a potential precursor to a hunger crisis in various parts of the world. But despite the humanitarian crisis and the cost of war, Russia is not backing down. Bloomberg Economics estimated in March 2023 that Russia had lost $350 billion in economic output since the start of the war due to a combination of sanctions and the war effort itself. The Center for Strategic and International Studies estimated in March 2023 that the cost of the war to Russia could reach $7 trillion over the next decade. While these estimates provide a stark picture of the economic and humanitarian costs, it's crucial to recognize that they remain preliminary. The full extent of the war's impact is yet to unfold, underscoring the urgency of concerted international efforts to address both the immediate crisis and its long-term aftermath. As the world watches and hopes for a resolution to the conflict, it's clear that the ramifications of the Russia-Ukraine war reverberate far beyond the borders of the nations directly involved. Bureau Report, WION. World is one.
Moving on, as per reports, President Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine continues to adversely impact Russia's economy.
And it has forced the leader to review his budget priorities. But instead of what at least NATO would have expected, Russia has now plans of a massive increase in defense spending next year.
I'd say, Shivan, this doesn't really come as much of a surprise. I guess this was expected at this point in the war.
What option do they have left right now?
Right.
They have to spend on it.
One would assume, right. And according to a Russian finance ministry document now published on Thursday, Russia is set to hike defense spending by almost 70% in 2024. The cost of the jump is calculated at over 10.8 trillion rubles. That's about 100 and $11 billion, totaling around 6% of the GDP. Further classified expenditures will rise to 11.1 trillion rubles from 6.5 trillion for 2023, and spending on social policies, that's planned to reach 7.5 trillion rubles in 2024, up from 6.5 trillion in 2023. Defense spending is set to total around three times more than education, environmental protection and healthcare spending combined in 2024. These are the figures that were calculated by AFP. Russian Finance Ministry document also stated that the increased expenditure will help boost strengthening the country's defense capacity and integrating the four Ukrainian regions, which Moscow claimed to annex last year. These are Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson and Zaporizhia. Now, the increased defense spending comes as Russia's central bank warns economic growth is set to slow down in the second half of 2023, with inflation above the bank's target of 4%. President Putin and other officials have largely shrugged off the economic effects of Ukraine offensive, arguing that Russia has largely weathered the storm of Western sanctions here.
Russian President Vladimir Putin has signed a decree setting out the routine seasonal conscription campaign. As per a document posted on Moscow's government website, he has called at least 130,000 citizens to contribute to statutory military service. The document states that all Russian men in the age bracket of 18 to 27 years are required to do a year-long military training. The move has followed through as the Russian armed forces continue to press on with their special military operation in Ukraine, the same war that is now in its 20th month. Early this year, another similar order was signed calling upon 100,047 people for the spring campaign. However, the recent announcement comes on the heels of President Putin's statement that this month his government is bracing for a longer battle in Ukraine. As per Moscow's defense ministry, the recent conscription will include, for the first time, men from four occupied regions in Ukraine. Men from Luhansk, Donetsk, Kherson, and Zaporizhia will be part of the induction. In fact, in July this year, Russia's lower house of parliament voted to raise the maximum age of conscription from 27 to 30 years. The new legislation has been given a green flag and will come into effect starting 1st of January next year. The large-scale forced mobilization has been coined due to substantial losses at the front and will unfold from October to December. Last year, Moscow trumpeted an ambitious plan to boost its professional and conscripted combatants. The decided jump in numbers was more than 30%, loosely making up about 1.5 million personnel. How are people reacting to this? Are they in favor of the move? Well, the UK Defence Intelligence assessed that high desertion betrays the morale of the Russian troops. However, at the same time, high military wages and additional payments serve as strong incentives for Russians to join into the ranks of Moscow's forces. These mass recruitments especially appeal to those residing in impoverished regions of Russia.
It is 5 months since the civil war broke out in Sudan, but the brutality and mayhem that began on the 15th of April continues unabated. This week, a video of two RSF soldiers standing in front of one of Khartoum's most iconic skyscrapers has gone viral. The skyscraper that towers over the Nile River has been reduced to a smoldering shell. The fact that cultural heritage sites of Sudan were being reduced to rubble in the Sudanese civil war is no secret. But what is new is the scale of the devastation that has come to light. At the same time, the street fighting in Sudan is also fast becoming a theater of a proxy war between the Wagner mercenaries and the agents of the Ukrainian intelligence agencies. Now, you may wonder, what role do Russia and Ukraine have to play in the civil war in Sudan? In our next report, we get you the details of how Ukraine is trying to crush the Wagner mercenaries inside Sudan.
This video from the 17th of September is from the Sudanese capital, Khartoum. Two RSF soldiers with their guns rested on their shoulders accused the Sudanese National Army of using air power to bomb civilian locations. This region is the confluence of the Blue and the White Niles. Until some months back, was the hub of Khartoum's financial district. In a recorded speech put out by the RSF militia chief General Degalo, he's warned that Sudan is again headed for yet another partition. So as the two generals battle it out for supremacy, the common people are the ones who are caught in a meat grinder. Driven out from their homes, they've pitched temporary tents along the border with Chad. In West Darfur, the civil war has again acquired a tribal and ethnic dimension. The non-Arab Masalit people are facing the brunt of violence here. From the beginning of the conflict, the Russian Wagner militia has been actively aiding the RSF paramilitary group of General Degalo. And now, a series of drone attacks on Wagner assets in Sudan is raising some very uncomfortable questions. Take a look at this dramatic video shot using a drone. Experts have geolocated this strike to have taken place on the Shambat Bridge, which connects Omdurman and Khartoum. In the last fortnight, a series of such drone attacks in Sudan have taken everyone by surprise. The tactic of drones swooping down directly onto the target has so far been unusual in Sudan and the wider African region. Interestingly, Ukraine has not directly claimed these attacks, but top sources within the Ukrainian military have admitted that attacks on Wagner militia in Khartoum and Omdurman are the handiwork of non-Sudanese military. The Sudanese National Army insists that it has no information on these attacks, while the Americans have refused to comment on the new drone tactics that are being witnessed. This video shot using a night vision camera is purportedly of foreign fighters conducting a raid on a building in Omdurman. On the 6th of September, the Wagner militia reportedly facilitated the transfer of a large convoy of arms to the RSF, including anti-air defense missiles. Covert strikes by Ukraine in Sudan points to a provocative expansion of the war theater. Drone tactics like this have earlier been used in the war theaters of Libya, Ethiopia, and Nigeria. But this is the first time that they've been deployed in the Sudanese civil war. And worryingly, it is an outside power that has now deployed them in the Sudanese conflict.
The war in Ukraine has stretched beyond 580 days now, and the tensions seem to be mounting along the front lines. The global economic order has changed significantly since February 2022, when the war began. So, what's the human cost of the ongoing war? What do the numbers suggest? Take a look and find out.
February 2022, Russia began its so-called military operation on Ukrainian soil. Ukraine has since found support among the United States and its allies, despite not being inducted into NATO. Economic sanctions since then have hit Russia hard, but the economic implications of the war stretch far beyond the countries involved and their allies. A globally interconnected supply chain means everyone in the world has felt the pain of the war. For developing countries like Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh and others, the World Bank's projection as of March 2023 is grim, suggesting that the Ukraine conflict could impose a hefty annual burden of $70 billion. This daunting figure stems from several factors, including surging food and energy prices, sluggish economic growth and disruptions in trade and investment. Advanced economies are not immune to the repercussions. The United States is facing the biggest losses. Some estimates suggest it could cost Uncle Sam $1.5 trillion over the next decade, while the Eurozone is expected to face losses over $1 trillion during this time. The German economy, currently in recession, is expected to fare the worst. But the economic losses faced by these countries is nowhere close to what it could cost Ukraine. The Kiev School of Economics estimated in March 2023 that the direct economic losses to Ukraine from the war could reach $500 billion. That is larger than Ukraine's pre-war GDP of $350 billion. Beyond the economic toll, the Ukraine war has also spawned a significant humanitarian crisis. Millions of Ukrainians have been forcibly displaced, their lives upended by violence and uncertainty. Tragically, thousands have lost their lives in the conflict. Moreover, the war's disruption of global food supplies looms as a potential precursor to a hunger crisis in various parts of the world. But despite the humanitarian crisis and the cost of war, Russia is not backing down. Bloomberg Economics estimated in March 2023 that Russia had lost $350 billion in economic output since the start of the war due to a combination of sanctions and the war effort itself. The Center for Strategic and International Studies estimated in March 2023 that the cost of the war to Russia could reach $7 trillion over the next decade. While these estimates provide a stark picture of the economic and humanitarian costs, it's crucial to recognize that they remain preliminary. The full extent of the war's impact is yet to unfold, underscoring the urgency of concerted international efforts to address both the immediate crisis and its long-term aftermath. As the world watches and hopes for a resolution to the conflict, it's clear that the ramifications of the Russia-Ukraine war reverberate far beyond the borders of the nations directly involved. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.
Moving on, as per reports, President Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine continues to adversely impact Russia's economy.
And it has forced the leader to review his budget priorities. But instead of what at least NATO would have expected, Russia has now plans of a massive increase in defense spending next year.
I'd say, Shivan, this doesn't really come as much of a surprise. I guess this was expected at this point in the war.
What option do they have left right now?
Right.
They have to spend on it.
One would assume, right. And according to a Russian finance ministry document now published on Thursday, Russia is set to hike defense spending by almost 70% in 2024. The cost of the jump is calculated at over 10.8 trillion rubles. That's about $111 billion, totaling around 6% of the GDP. Further classified expenditures will rise to 11.1 trillion rubles from 6.5 trillion for 2023, and spending on social policies, that's planned to reach 7.5 trillion rubles in 2024, up from 6.5 trillion in 2023. Defense spending is set to total around three times more than education, environmental protection and healthcare spending combined in 2024. These are the figures that were calculated by AFP. Russian Finance Ministry document also stated that the increased expenditure will help boost strengthening the country's defense capacity and